So this here is first reproduction of a pair of Bronze Age horns from County Antrim. You can see this one here, it's got quite a conventional mouthpiece on end on it here. It's a straightforward looking horn. But this one is very unusual because it's got the mouthpiece there in the side of the instrument, and it's a big, wide open mouthpiece. You can see that.
Thank you. said that it was ridiculous, but Danny said,
some people just have star power. Could you feel it?
I started playing when I was 6 years old. I hope Australia thinks that I'm really good at the trumpet tonight.
Playing brass with class, it's little Bobby Harrison.
Depuis quel âge?
5 ans et demi.
5 ans et demi. Comment on commence à 5 ans?
Eh oui, je trouve que les enfants commencent de plus en plus tôt.
Eh
maintenant.
Oui, tu as la trouille, toi. Hein? Tu
oui,
te dis, ils vont me tomber dessus.
Jours.
Tu es au conservatoire de Bruxelles?
On écoute, mesdames, messieurs, on écoute.
She's brought her fellow Norwegian players to the BBC Proms. Here at Cadogan Hall, they begin their concert with music from Bizet's opera, Carmen.
The bell on a Bach trumpet goes through many steps to acquire its classic shape and the unique Bach sound. We start with a single piece of stamped brass and give it curves. Our bell specialist brings the two edges together to create a seam and hammers along the length of the metal. One-piece construction lets the bell vibrate without restriction. It's all part of the famous Bach Strad sound. Fusion paste seals the seam as he brazes it. The torch can exceed 2,000 degrees. That's as hot as molten lava. Vincent Bach discovered that the best sounding bells are not a uniform thickness. We create slight variations in the thickness of the bell's walls. We also heat treat our trumpets. This tempering process, known as annealing, is part of the Bach secret sauce. We shape the bell around a solid steel mandrel. Scribing the end of the bell trims off excess metal. The artisan pulls back the brass around the outside edge of the bell. We don't stop there, though. Watch while a wire ring is added to the inside of the rim. The ring helps keep the bell from collapsing. Forcing solder into the rim increases the bell's responsiveness. Details like these can have a dramatic impact on how the bell resonates and are part of what creates the... The good vibration starts with the lips and a mouthpiece. At Bach, great manufacturing also starts with mouthpieces. We take solid brass bars and place them in a computer-controlled machine that meticulously shapes and cuts the bars into mouthpieces. We program the machine so that each step, trimming the brass bars, shaping the rim, creating the mouthpiece shank that fits into the lead pipe, is precise within 1/1000th of an inch. We call it precision manufacturing. The history of Bach trumpets starts with mouthpieces too. A century ago, trumpet player Vincent Bach needed to replace a ruined mouthpiece and began experimenting with designs and manufacturing processes. Mouthpieces led to trumpets. Bach's pleased customers told him, "Vincent, this is the Stradivarius of trumpets." That's how Bach's trumpets acquired a name from the legendary Italian violin maker Stradivarius, a name synonymous with the very best. Our Stradivarius trumpets are still based on Bach's original designs. In the Bach plant today, we proudly continue the tradition of American-made
The music written by Miles Davis, he calls So What? Thank you.
Today we're recording in a church called St. Jude's in Hampstead Garden suburb. For the trumpet, the church is a wonderful space because its sound just blooms and blossoms and makes my job a lot easier. The music is a wide variety of Purcell and Handel, with period instruments, with the English concert and Trevor Pinnock directing, and a couple of wonderful soloists, Yeston Davies and Lucy Crowe.
Glory.